it's not just about a glass of wine. Wine is about history, terroir, love, life, and even romance.
Tita Margarita gets emotional over wine. Or is it because of wine?
How can I not, when there's so much history behind the label? We meet Giovanni Matse, who belongs to a long, long line of Matses.
The history of my family goes down to the 11th century. And my family back in the days, they're actually from a little town next to Florence. They were artisans making barrels for wine. So my family has a strong linkage with the wine industry since 1435. So come closer. Here we go. Most of the information that we have about our family and about the farming here at Fonterutoli. So there's all the balance sheet all in these folders that are dated down to the 1400 till today. So all our secrets are here.
See what I mean? The family has been producing wine at this historic property in the heart of the Chianti Classico region for an astounding 24 generations. And they are one of the 10 oldest family enterprises in Italy.
Well, my family have dedicated their life to this terroir, this region, and of course to the main variety of the region, which is Sangiovese.
Okay.
Why we did that? I mean, basically, where we're sitting now, where we are now, we are about 450 meters from the sea level. We're actually quite high in altitude for the Sangiovese. And my family wanted to make something that's really unique, distinguished, and recognizable. And that's for me, you know, when you drink wine, what you're expecting by a nice glass of wine is to understand where it's from. Mm. And then only understanding where it's from and how it's made it, you can have an emotion.
Esattamente, hai ragione. Understanding where the wine is from and how it's made allows you to have an emotional connection.
The soil is very interesting, as you can see, it's full of rock, but it's not too tight. So roots can really grow well down.
The tradition may be centuries old, but the cellars are anything but. Designed by Giovanni's aunt, Agnesi Matse, the modern wine cellar is largely underground, using the force of gravity to drop the grapes.
And it's calcareous, so the water dripping down through the rock.
75 winemaking steel vats take up an entire floor below. Deeper underground, 15 meters to be exact, is a vast cellar where more than 3,000 barrels dwell.
We make our way above ground to where Giovanni is hosting a wine pairing dinner in one of the many lovely stone houses in this charming hamlet. Joe Petreas, who represents Premium Wine Exchange in Manila, happens to be at Matse as well.
We start with the Prosecco Villa Marcello, a perfect welcome drink to get the party started.
Cheers to your family. Amazing. Cheers.
And then one of my favorite dishes is served. We're having a lovely beef tartare with some beautiful anchovies and some wonderful egg yolk. And to go with the beef tartare, a fruity and medium-bodied vermentino.
Goes well with the tartare.
I think so. I think it goes great with the tartare.
Very nice.
So what are we having now?
I don't have a clue.
Okay. That's a good thing. We can discover. We're going to discover together.
You told me. I don't know.
It was soup, a hot bowl of creamy potato and leek soup, best paired with a Fonterutoli Chianti Classico, an elegant and smooth wine with dark berry and fresh spice flavors.
This is the 2016 vintage we're having right now. Matteo, we just started carrying Matse 1 year ago.
You didn't introduce it to my restaurant yet.
I will. No, when we get back to Manila, it's already in your restaurant. Okay. So a little fun fact about this wine. Actually, you can see here like a black rooster. This is the symbol of Chianti. Before, Florence and Siena, these two cities, they fought over who will own the Chianti region. They said, okay, why don't we send out two riders, one from Florence, one from Siena.
So the legend goes, the Florentines relied on a black rooster, which haven't been left without food, crowed well before daybreak, allowing the knight from Florence to start with a great advantage and travel a longer way, covering more land.
Wait, but you forgot what? To say they met in Fonterutoli.
They met in Fonterutoli.
They actually met in Fonterutoli.
That's why we are in the edge of.
So here you are 45 kilometers from Florence and 15 kilometers from Siena. And this vintage, which is 2016, is the celebration of the 300 years of the Chianti Classico, which was recognized by Leopoldo in the 1716.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Ching
ching.
Yeah. Salute. This one, I feel like it's something I can have all the time.
Ah, cinghiale. You must have cinghiale in Tuscany. Wild boar is a Tuscan specialty. Giovanni recommends the siepi to go with the cinghiale. Siepi is a combination of Sangiovese and Merlot grapes. Siepi is one of the five areas of the Castello.
We actually have found a document that says that Siepi was a vineyard already in 1461.
Wow.
It's good, isn't it?
Yes. Super.
You got this, what I like is that the two varieties are very complementary. You got the silkiness, the elegance, and of the Sangiovese with the chocolate and the velvety, the round and the suppleness of the Merlot.
How I wish we had white rice to go with this.
Yeah, that'd be perfect, huh?
The rice gave me away. You can take the Filipino out of the Philippines, but you can't take the Philippines out of the Filipino. So much for being Italian in my past life.
Cheers.
Cheers, salute.